I am Dr. Kamala Sundaram, Program Assistant, Pharmacovigilance, Siddha Central Research Institute, Chennai. From the last days of this knowledge festival, we enrich our knowledge about the immune system, immune disorders and disease, and immune-boosting medicine, yoga, diet, etc. Whenever we talk about the medicine, we have to be too vigilant. So I choose this topic, pharmacovigilance view of immunosuppressive herbal drugs used in the Siddha system of medicine. The next introduction. In this introduction part, I just give the synopsis for this presentation. So first, the immune system plays an essential and a significant role in the protecting the body against pathogens. Autoimmune diseases are caused due to the imbalance in the immune system. Immunosuppressive herbs in the Siddha system of medicines are more effective in the treatment of the autoimmune disorders. So the physicians are used these herbs widely for the successful practice. For the purpose
doctor,
of that
is... Your microphone is possibly somewhere, there is some scratching noise or something. Just everything else is fine. It's just a little noise on it. Just
for the purpose of drugs, is it right now how it is, sir?
I'm not sure. Maybe it's a little better, because maybe it's also not scratch. It's just the breath. Maybe it's just too sensitive, the microphone. But we'll find out. It was a little better. So just don't worry. I mean, it's not too bad anyway.
Shall I continue, sir?
Yes. Go ahead, please.
Yes. For the purpose of drug safety, this presentation explains the ADR caused by the immunosuppressive herbs in the Siddha medicine. Immunity refers to the relative state of a resistance of the host to the infectious agents. Immunity protects against the infectious disease. Immunity distinguishes the self from non-self. This is the main core of this topic. So I highlight this. And immunity eliminates the potentially destructive foreign substances from the body. I just describe about the autoimmune disorder. An autoimmune disease is a condition in which our immune system mistakenly attacks our body. Normally, the immune system can identify the difference between the foreign cells and our own cells. But in autoimmune disorder, the immune system does not distinguish between the healthy tissue and potentially harmful antigens. As a result, the body releases the protein called autoantibodies that destroys the normal tissues. Some autoimmune diseases target only one organ. Example, type 1 diabetes, it targets the pancreas one. But some autoimmune diseases target the whole body. Example, systemic lupus erythematosus. Immunosuppressive effect of herbal medicine. The capacity of a herbal medicine to inhibit cellular and humoral immune responses can have useful application in some immune-mediated disorders, including autoimmune diseases. Both activation of a T and B lymphocytes and macrophages and defective apoptosis of immune effector cells play critical roles in the pathogenesis of this disorder. Just give the autoimmune diseases. More than 80 common autoimmune diseases are identified. Among 80, the 14 is more common autoimmune diseases. In this, type 1 diabetes and rheumatoid arthritis, psoriasis and psoriatic arthritis, multiple sclerosis and systemic lupus erythematosus and inflammatory bowel disease and pernicious anemia. These are all the diseases are frequently treated with the herbal medicine. So I just highlight these things. Then the common single herbs used to treat the autoimmune disorder. So these are all the common single herbs used to treat the autoimmune disorders. That's Vitania somnifera, Thinospora cardifolia, Curcuma longa, Glycyrrhiza glabra, Zingiber officinal, Andrographis paniculata, Allium sativa, and Camellia sinensis. Camellia sinensis is a green tea which is not in the Siddha system of medicine, but it is widely used for the autoimmune disorder, so I put it here. So these are all the immunosuppressive action which is given for the reference. First, Ithania somnifera, the chemical constituent present in the ashwagandha, that is Ithania somnifera or alkaloids, steroidals, saponins and methanoloids, these constituents produce an immunosuppressive action on B and T cell activity in hyperimmune status. And glycyrrhiza glabra, glycyrrhizin and glycyrrhinic acid are the active constituents which have the immunosuppressive action. So glycyrrhizin lead to a reduction of TLR4 expression in the heart and lung cells. This was accompanied by the significant reduction of cytokine release, that is the release of TNF-alpha and interleukin-6 and interleukin-1-beta. And then Thymospora cordifolia. The immunomodulator property of the Thymospora cordifolia extract was validated by assessing its effect on activating resting macrophages and by estimating the generation of a secretory factors like enterocytes and lysosomes. And curcuma longa, curcumin has been shown to be active on lymphocytes and affects a series of immunological functions, including antigen presentation, humoral and cell-mediated immunity, and cytokine production. Ginger of his name. The 8 gingerol is one of the principal component of ginger. This could suppress humoral and cellular immune response in mice. The mechanism might be related to direct inhibition of sensitized T and B lymphocytes. Andrography spanulata. It has the inhibitory effect on NF-kappa-B transactivation activity and also inhibit the nitric oxide and prostaglandin A2. Allium sativum, garlic has shown to reduce the pro-inflammatory cytokines, interleukins, TNF-alpha and interleukins-8 and stimulate the interleukin-10 secretion. Interleukin-10 is an antagonist of the pro-inflammatory cytokines and therefore this effect may be potential mechanism justifying the garlic's use in the inflammatory diseases. The Camellia sinensis, that's a green tea. The epigallocatechin 3 gallate, a component of a green tea with an anti-inflammatory and immunomodulatory activities, this compound has shown the inhibitory effects on human monocyte-derived disease and consequently on the T-cell-mediated immune responses. Till now, I explain about the immunity and autoimmune disorders and the herbs used in the autoimmune disorders to suppress the immunity for the better results. So I just move to the core of this presentation, the pharmacovigilance. The pharmacovigilance is the science and activities relating to the detection, assessment, understanding and prevention of the adverse effect or any other medicine, vaccine related problems. In Siddha, the adverse reaction is explained as a kallapini in Kannasamy Pillai Maruthuva Kudam and Kannasamy and Vaidya Sara Sangritam. The kallapini is the synonyms for the adverse drug reaction. It describes the drugs cures the indicated disease but subsequently causes the other illness too. That's known as kallapini. This drug should not be considered as a medicine. As per this Siddha literature, wherever the drug causes the illness to the patient, this drug should not be considered as the medicine. So what could be the medicine? It is expressed by Thirukkural. This is ancient Tamil literature. In this literature, Marandu is in Marandu Adhigaram, Uttravan Thirpan Marandurai Selvan Endru Appal Naar Kutre Marandu. The medicine is not only the chemical compound, this is a component of the responsibility of a patient, doctor, and medicine, that's a manufacturer and the pharmacist. I just explained why, because whenever we have a lack of knowledge or lack of practice, a better practice in the patient or doctor or manufacturer or pharmacist, we lead to the ADR. So the occurrence of the ADRs are due to the doctors or by patients or by the medicines, that is manufacturer or dispensing pharmacist. So how it is occurs? Error in diagnosis, error in selection of the drug, error in combination of the drug that may lead to the drug interaction, and diet advice and duration of the treatment. The chronic duration may lead to the cumulative effect of the drugs, and come to the patient, ignore the doctor's advice. and error in the medicine dosage and error in the vehicle, misuse of the drug, it may be a route of administration too, and duration of the medicine. And come to the pharmacy side, error in medicine preparation. Whenever we did the error in medicine preparation, it may lead to the ADR and error in dispensing the medicine. These are all the causes for the ADRs. Then why people choose a herbal medicine? Because people always choose a herbal medicine. They always believe natural is always safe. A herbal medicine are cost effective than modern medicine. Herbal medicine can be brought without a prescription. People believe herbal medicine do not have any side effect as they are free from chemicals. So their belief is not true always. No medicine is absolutely safe for all the people in all the places at all the time. So there is a monitoring center for the medicine. That's Uppsala Monitoring Center, which is a WHO collaborating center for the international drug monitoring. Still now, so many ADRs are reported here. I just give the examples for this presentation. I just deliver the 8 plants, so which is reported ADRs. Vitania somnifera, number of ADRs 42, Tynospora cordifolia 36, and Curcuma longa 162, and Glycyrrhiza glabra 172, and more ADRs are reported to the Andrographis paniculata, and the Gingivora officinale is one of the common plant we are using, that's also reporting 237. This is a worldwide report. This is a VG access. So I get from this database of the VG base. So when we search the plant name, I just put the Andrographis paniculata. There is 329 ADRs are reported still now. So they give the adverse drug reaction by system organ classification. Likewise, blood and lymphatic systems, cardiac system, ear, eye disorders, and gastrointestinal disorder. For Andrographis paniculata, the gastrointestinal disorders, I choose it. For this, the vomiting is more, and then nausea, diarrhea is also here. For next, they also give the geographical distribution, and then the age distribution. The common age group having the ADRs for the Andrographis paniculata is of 18 to 44 years, and the patient sex distribution is a female or more prone for the ADR for the Andrographis paniculata. This is the year. I just skip to this. So submission to this forum, kindly report ADR regarding the herbal medicine. Herbal medicine is also the medicine. So this is safe to the people. I need to register this. We have to report ADR. It is a major tool to the standardize and globalize our traditional system of medicine. So patient safety is more than anything, more than science. And thank you all. Take and tell together for a safer medicine. I thank for giving me the opportunity to this knowledge festival organizing team. I need to register my thanks to my coordinator, Dr. M. Kannan, and for his great support and guidance. And I extend my thanks to Director in Charge and to DG Ma'am CCRS. Thank you all.